Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make this card decal. So I'm going to show you guys how to do this in Cricut Design Space, and I'm going to show you guys a few tips and tricks along the way. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so I've brought my design over here in Cricut Design Space. Now this is currently a free design. I'll have it linked down below over on Design Bundles. So I've already brought this in here and now we're ready to go. Now something that I need to fix here, sometimes this happens from time to time where a couple small pieces, I call them strays, will be kind of lingering and it's like, what do you do with those? So if you look over here on the right hand side, you'll notice this tiny little guy here and you'll see it kind of light up. You'll see, I'm going to click on something else and then click there. You can see where it kind of highlights. So if we click on this one, you'll see it pop up right over here, right? So we have to figure out what pieces those belong to. So both of these pieces here actually belong to this white ball here. So they just simply need to be attached. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down the command button on my desktop. And I'm going to click on these other pieces and hit weld. So now they're in one piece. So you can see here, I no longer have those teensy tiny pieces. So if something like that happens to you, just figure out which pieces it belongs to and weld it or attach. Now, two different ways I want to show you that you can actually utilize this, actually a couple different ways. So for example, you could get rid of this circle right here. So if you want it to just be this piece right here, so you'd be able to see all the way through the ball. So you could definitely just do this, or you would have this piece that comes with it and you would just have to line it up so very carefully right on top or underneath and just line up these stitch marks to make sure everything lines up. So you could do that. Or you could definitely replace this with a new circle. So we could come over here to shapes, hit circle. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to size this to the same size as this. So we're going to click this and it's actually 7.89 by 7.86. I'm going to go by the bigger side here, which is 7.89. I'm going to click it here and we're going to go 7.89. Now keep in mind, I could have came down here and hit the unlock button and did the same numbers that are right here. So I could do 786, 786 if I wanted to, but I'm not going to worry about that. So now I have this. So if I actually change it to white and I come up here to arrange, hit send to the back. So there it is. So that way, whenever I go to do this, and that's how I'm going to do it today, I don't have to worry about these tiny little stitch marks and lining everything up. I've now just got that little ball right there in the back. Well, some of you may say, well, why didn't you just hit the contour? Well, that doesn't work every single time. So for example, these are open. See these little open marks right here? That will cause a problem. So if you have open pieces, it will not completely seal up. Let me show you. So if we click on this one right here, we come down to contour and we hit hide all contours like we normally would, this is what you're going to be left with. So wherever there is open gaps, those are going to be open. So this is open here, but it travels all the way down here. So the next break was somewhere right in here. So those were able to seal up. So sometimes the contour doesn't work every single time. So if it's a simple shape like a square or a circle, you could definitely just take a new shape and pop it right on top. Now, this is the way that I'm going to do it because I find it so much easier to line everything up. Now for our next step is sizing it down. So I want to go ahead and change my machine because today I'm using the Joy. So you're going to come right over here to the top right, change it to the Joy. And right away, you're going to notice we're going to get these warnings saying that the image is way too big for the mats, right? So I'm going to hit select all because I want to make sure I'm selecting both. And I want to cut this around 4.5 wide. Just like that. So now you notice both of those are going to go away and we're good to go. So now we're ready to simply cut these out. Today we're using the Cricut Joy and I'm also using the Smart Material. So I'm using Cricut's Smart Material adhesive, say that 10 times fast, and I'm just going to load those one at a time. What's awesome about the Smart Materials is I don't have to have a mat. I can simply load it right in my machine and I'm good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and cut out both of these. This machine is perfect for car decals. So now I'm just going to go ahead and weed everything out. Now I know it's hard to tell with this white, but I promise you there is a circle there. So I've got my circle and now I'm going to weed out the
the other side, the black piece. Now, when it comes to the Cricut Joy, I don't know what it is, but this thing can cut small, intricate stuff like a breeze. So if you've ever struggled with anything intricate, check out that Cricut Joy. I love it. So I'm just going to simply weed everything out, and now we are ready to line them up. So what you want to do is you're going to take the piece that's going to be on top first, so your final layer, which is this piece right here, and I'm gonna go ahead and lay it on top of our transfer sheet. So you wanna use, if this is something that you're selling, you wanna use a clear transfer sheet, and you could definitely get contact paper from the Dollar Tree, and that is perfect. So what you're gonna do is just take your scraper tool and really rub that down to get it to adhere to the transfer sheet. Now I will say, when it comes to the Cricut Joy Smart Material, this backing's so thick that sometimes it is hard to pull off of the transfer sheet, if you will. So I'm going to go ahead and line this up. So you're just going to hover right above the other piece, so that circle, and then you're going to lay it down and just rub everything in. Now, if this is something that you are going to sell, you definitely just want to trim all the way around nice and neatly, and then it'll be an item that you can put on a shelf or sell on your Etsy or whatever. Now, you'll notice I'll just trim that little piece off just because it was overhang. And now it's ready to apply to the car. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.